she's built up for the future. What happens tomorrow depends on what you need to today. The big man tells you to chop the ideas of truth. He does not think of his own children who tomorrow will live in a world without trees.
A great toadstalk had begun climbing down from the canopy when the man first appeared. Only now did he reach the ground, plodding ever so slowly to the sleeping man. He spoke in his deep and lazy voice.
Señor, how much is beauty worth? Can you live without it? If you destroy the beauty of the rainforest, or what would it be for us?
The child from the Yanomamo tribe who lived in the rainforest knelt over the sleeping man. She murmured in his ear.
The man awoke with a start. Before him stood the rainforest child, and all around him staring were the creatures who depended upon the rain cave proper. What was this rare animal to them? The man looked about and saw his son, Strange and beautiful plants seemed to dangle in the air, suspended from the great cave proper. The man smelled the fragrant perfume of the flowers. He felt the steamy mist rising from the forest floor, but he heard no sound. But the creatures were strangely silent. The man stood up and picked up his axe. He swung back his arm as though to strike the tree. Suddenly he stopped. He turned to look at the animals and the child. He hesitated. Then he dropped the axe and walked out of the rain.